The Owen James Report is brought to you by...
This program is brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care. Grace Kennedy Money Services has been here for you and your family, here and abroad, because we understand that you're receiving more than money. You're receiving their love. Grace Kennedy Financial Group has been here for you because we know it's more than just investments, insurance, or banking. It's about security and creating a path to realizing your dreams. For 90 years, honesty, integrity, and trust. The Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report. An increase of 12% in the minimum wage last month was mainly responsible for a 50 basis point increase in the inflation rate in January. Data from the Statistical Institute showed that while all other divisions recorded increases under 1%, the division furnishings, household equipment, and routine household maintenance recorded the highest increase of almost 3%. The fiscal year-to-date inflation movement was 7.1%, or consistent with the Bank of Jamaica's projections. On the foreign exchange market, the benchmark American dollar strengthened by 2 Jamaican cents, closing at an average selling rate of $107.87. However, both the Canadian dollar and the British pound weakened against the local currency. The Canadian dollar fell by 6 Jamaican cents, closing at $98.09, whilst sterling fell by 49 cents Jamaican to close at an average selling rate of $180.13. The stock market indices fell marginally at the start of the new financial week, following declines in stocks such as Grace Kennedy, NCB, and Scotia Investments. The main JSE index fell by 178 points, or a fifth of 1%. 30 stocks traded, with 8 advancing, 10 declining, and 12 holding firm. Winners included Carreras, JMMB, Jamaican Teas up 14.7%, Lasco Financial Services, and Scotia Group. The losers included Consolidated Bakeries down over 4%, Grace Kennedy, NCB, Sagicor's Real Estate X Fund, and Scotia Investments. Now finally, the three Lasco companies listed on the junior market have combined to bolster the group's profit to $1 billion for the nine-month period ended December 31, 2013. Here's a snapshot of the financials of each. Lasco Distributors increased its revenue by 12.2% to $7 billion, with profit growing by 11.5% to $233 million. Lasco Financial Services experienced a revenue growth of 42% to $483 million in the same period. Lasco Manufacturing saw nine-month revenue growing by over 8% to almost $3 billion. Now, the Lasco Group is usually viewed as representing the true success story of the junior market concept, which has contributed significantly to the growth and development of over 19 small companies over the past 2 years. And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report was brought to you by Grace Kennedy.
This program was brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.